All sorts of terrible things happen in war, but it's a breeding ground for the strange as well. One war that receives very little attention, at least in the West, is the Sino-Indian War of 1962, and another that gets even less attention is the Sino-Indian War of 1967, which basically set the stage for a particularly strange event that took place about a year later. In this video, we delve into the story of Baba Harbhajan Singh, as well as provide an overview of the Sino-Indian War of 1967, or as some refer to it, the Nathu Lu and Chola clashes. Globally, 1967 was a pretty tense year. It was the middle of the Cold War and the Western and Eastern Bloc were at each other's throats. Following the Sino-Indian War of 1962, which resulted in thousands of deaths, things on the border of India and China were understandably tense. Indian and Chinese forces stationed near the border were at a range of different proximities from each other, owing very much to the terrain. But at one spot, the two opposing forces were literally only about 20 to 30 meters apart. This spot was Nathu Lu, a mountain pass where Sikkim, now an Indian state, connects with China's Tibet or Xinjiang Autonomous Region. Throughout August and early into September 1967, the Indians and Chinese had more than a little trouble figuring out exactly where to draw the line, the boundary line, that is. The Chinese dug trenches in what the Indians believed to be Indian territory. The Indians spoke up and the Chinese backed off a bit. Then, the Indians started setting up a barrier of barbed wire across the boundary, and this angered the Chinese, who started harassing the Indian soldiers installing said wire. A verbal argument turned into some roughhousing, and on the 11th of September, the roughhousing devolved into a small-scale war. In the words of an Indian officer present, the Chinese went back to their bunkers and our engineers resumed laying the wire. Within a few minutes, a whistle was heard on the Chinese side, followed by murderous machine gun fire. The pass is completely devoid of cover, and 70 field company and 18 Rajput were caught in the open and suffered heavy casualties. After the Indians regathered themselves, they opened up with artillery fire and suffered Chinese artillery in turn. Fueled by artillery, mortar, and machine gun fire, and even some hand-to-hand combat, the fighting continued until the 14th of September, after which as many as 101 Indians and 340 Chinese were dead. All in all, it was a resounding victory for the Indians. At one point, an Indian soldier with the exact same name as Harbhajan Singh, but not our Harbhajan Singh, fell in battle and was rewarded the Mahavir Chakra military decoration. The citation read, "After bayoneting three Chinese soldiers, he moved forward and silenced their LMG, which was firing on men in the open, by throwing a hand grenade. In doing so, he made the supreme sacrifice of his life." In this action, Major Harbhajan Singh displayed conspicuous gallantry and determination of a high order. But where does our Harbhajan Singh come into all of this? Our Harbhajan Singh was born in 1946 in the village of Sadrana, Punjab. At just 20 years of age, he joined the army and was recruited into the Punjab regiment, which was posted to the Indo-China border. While it's unclear if he took part in the Sino-Indian War of 1967, he was in the area by October 1968, when tragedy struck. While escorting a column of mules on the 4th of October, he slipped off the side of a mountain into a fast-flowing and probably freezing cold river and drowned. Initially, Singh was branded a deserter, but then his body was found 2 kilometers or 1.2-ish miles downstream about 3 days later. His body was cremated with full military honors. But that was only the tragic, so what about the strange? While we of course cannot prove this, it is said that Singh's spirit stayed on, continuing to do his duty as a soldier. Visiting another Indian soldier in a dream, supposedly, Singh said that he wanted a shrine erected in his memory. So the army got to work, building what came to be known as Baba Harbhajan Singh Temple just south of Nathu Lu Mountain Pass. If any of this is to be believed, the temple essentially anchored Singh's spirit to the world of the living, allowing his posthumous legend to grow. It's said that Singh, given the title Baba, meaning something along the lines of saintly father, still defends the mountain pass, with both Indian and Chinese soldiers claiming to have seen him. While it doesn't appear that Singh's spirit has killed anyone or anything, it is said that he warns both the Indians and Chinese about impending altercations and environmental hazards. In the words of an Indian colonel interviewed in 2017 by the Indian news magazine India Today, the Indian Army has great faith in Baba's legendary powers. Each unit and reinforcement which cross the route moves ahead after taking his blessings. Legend has it that water left at Singh's temple, which is actually kitted out like a small house, can take on healing properties. Others claim that Singh maintains his personal effects in his bedroom inside the temple, ensuring that his military attire, in particular, is clean and tidy as he kept it in life. Stepping away from the paranormal just a little, Singh was kept on the Indian Army registers after death and was even promoted to an honorary captain, with his paycheck being sent to his family up until 2019 when he finally retired. What's even weirder is that Singh, a dead man, we remind you, gets annual leave. As is tradition, for Singh's annual leave, which lasts from the 15th of September to the 15th of November, some of his belongings, and supposedly his spirit with them, are driven from his temple to the nearest train station and then carried by rail to his family in the village of Kuka, Punjab, with three Indian Army soldiers to escort him. Throughout these months, it's said that Indian units posted on the Indo-China border go into a sort of high alert, fearing the Chinese might take advantage of Baba Singh's absence. Whenever Indian and Chinese forces put aside their differences to hold meetings near the border, the Chinese go as far as to set aside an extra chair for Singh to sit on. According to one Indian soldier, who was also interviewed in 2017 by India Today, it is not just the Indian Army. The Chinese Army also believes in Baba's spirit. The dragon is scared of him. To this day, Baba Harbhajan Singh Temple remains a popular destination for tourists visiting Sikkim, and a stable part of Indian Army culture. So this one was a bit of a weird one, but we're always keen to know what you think. Had you heard of either Sino-Indian War before this video? What do you think about Baba Harbhajan Singh? Do you think all that stuff about Singh's spirit is BS, or do you think there's some truth to it? Let us know all that and more in the comment section below. And just before clicking off to the next video, guys, make sure you check out our all new channel called The Braved, where we go through all different eras of history, not just World War II, to find some of the most badass individuals from all these different eras, and we put it together in a very, very high quality way. So I'm sure you guys will love it. That link is first in the description below. And if you just want to listen to some mad beats, we have our Relax Jack music channel in the description below, as well as our wider community on Instagram, Facebook, and Discord. Anyways, guys, as always, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you learned something new.